Welcome to A Vista into the World of Wondrous Ideas, Signifying Man's Achievements. A step into the future with predictions of constructive things to come. Tomorrow offers new frontiers in science, adventure, and ideals. The atomic age, the challenge of outer space, and the hope for a peaceful, unified world. Walt Disney said that about Disneyland's Tomorrowland in 1955. And here, in Magic Kingdom's Tomorrowland and Walt Disney World, the story of the future actually begins long ago in the past. Because while Walt Disney was fascinated with the future and the newest technological advances, it was really less about outer space battles, aliens, or science fiction. It was more about practical science of the future. Because by the time science fiction stories featuring the likes of Buck Rogers and Flash Gordon became popular, Walt was already a man in his early 30s in charge of an ever-growing, very busy animation studio. Walt's vision of the future was science factual, not science fictional. For his shows on his weekly Disneyland television series, he consulted with top scientists of the day and only wanted to explore the possibilities of the immediate future that included realistic options for space travel, the benefits of future advancements in medicine, the use of communication satellites, and so much more. For example, he consulted with Wernher von Braun, the designer of the famous World War II V-2 rocket for his native Germany. Von Braun eventually became director of NASA's new flight center in Huntsville, Alabama, where he and his team developed the Saturn rockets that launched men to the moon in 1969. Von Braun served as technical director on three space-related television films that Disney produced in the 1950s. And together, Walt and Von Braun used TV to illustrate the strength of technology and the spirit of human imagination. In fact, Walt Disney personally introduced the first television show, Man in Space, which aired on ABC in 1955, to help demonstrate how to combine, quote, the tools of our trade with the knowledge of the scientists to give a factual picture of the latest plans for man's newest adventure. He later called the show Science Factual. So Walt wasn't just entertaining his viewers, he was educating them on how the world as a whole was moving into the future. Tomorrowland and Disneyland, which opened with the park in 1955, was the realized culmination of his views in a living, breathing, three-dimensional form, which guests couldn't just watch, but could actively participate in. Walt said, quote, tomorrow can be a wonderful age. Our scientists today are opening the doors of the space age to achievements that will benefit our children and generations to come. The Tomorrowland attractions have been designed to give you an opportunity to participate in adventures that are a living blueprint of our future. Walt's vision of Tomorrowland was very specific, that it would represent the city of the future in nearly 30 years, the world of 1986. That date was chosen because it was the next scheduled appearance of Halley's Comet, and hopefully be a time when trips to the moon would be commonplace and true robotics would exist. Walt's original Tomorrowland featured no flying saucers, aliens from outer space, or swarms of robots, but instead offered a simulated flight to the moon based on real-world technology and data, and a semi-futuristic highway system to train the young drivers of tomorrow, called the Autopia. When Tomorrowland opened at Walt Disney World on October 1st, 1971, it looked much different than Disneyland's on its opening day. In fact, Tomorrowland opened with only two attractions in operation. Can you guess what they were? And surprisingly, they were attractions that neither used futuristic technologies nor did they represent a glimpse into the distant future. The opening day attractions were the Skyway to Fantasyland, an aerial tramway system based on technology originally developed in the 1800s, and the Grand Prix Raceway, based on an international car race rather than the futuristic roadways of Disneyland's Autopia.